For years, stem cells have been used to treat things like blood disorders, immune conditions, and assist in recovery from chemotherapy. But now, scientists are unlocking their full potential. We're seeing breakthroughs in longevity, tissue regeneration, and even organ repair. And the best part? Some of these treatments are already here and are being tested in real people right now. And I'm one of those people. Stem cell therapy. It's one of the most exciting and rapidly advancing fields in regenerative medicine. Scientists and clinicians are uncovering new ways to tap into the body's repair system. They slow aging, heal injuries, even reverse certain age-related conditions. Now, the science is moving fast, and the possibilities, well, they're limitless. In this video, I'm going to take you through the latest advancements in stem cell science, explaining how these powerful cells work, and explore the real-world applications that are changing lives. Maybe you're considering therapy. Maybe you're just curious. Either way, this is a journey into a future where aging and longevity could be redefined. If you're serious about extending your health span, you don't have to do it alone. Join the Longevity Alliance, my free school community where you get immediate access to my free beginner's longevity course, The Foundations of Longevity. You can join in on weekly live Q&A sessions. You can engage with an active group of people just like you on a mission to optimize their health. Share your wins. Ask those burning longevity questions. And learn from those who are making longevity their priority. And best of all, it's 100% free, now and forever. Click the link in the description below or right up here to join, or just to check us out. In 2022 and 2023, I received stem cell therapy at the Regenerative Medicine Institute in Costa Rica. Now, these weren't the only treatments that I got there, but they were the treatments that seemed to have had the most profound effects on my health. Now, if you haven't seen those videos, check them out right up here. Anyway, the field has advanced in the last couple of years, so I thought it was time for a revisit. Now, this is one of the most exciting areas in regenerative medicine today. So just to recap, stem cells are undifferentiated cells, meaning that they aren't yet what they eventually will become. They can transform and become muscle, bone, skin. They turn into functioning cells of the body, also known as somatic cells. Every cell in your body started this way. Now, there's a reservoir of stem cells in different tissues. Bone marrow is the largest source. It contains a variety of stem cells that can be used to build just about any cell in the body. But it's not the only source. Adipose tissue or fat, as well as muscle, dental pulp, and a few other tissues all contain stem cells, but in smaller amounts. Now, when an injury occurs, stem cells are mobilized from these tissues. They enter the bloodstream and they seek out whatever damage is happening. The unfortunate part of the story is that as you get older, the quality of your stem cells starts to decline. So it is the number of circulating stem cells in your blood. Now, this directly affects your ability to repair and maintain your body. This process is known as stem cell exhaustion. Wounds take longer to heal. Exercise recovery slows down. Joints wear down, leading to osteoarthritis. Years of sun exposure leads to the deterioration of the skin. Now, this pattern is duplicated in every tissue in your body. But stem cell therapy offers a way around this decline. Clinics can either add fresh stem cells from other sources, or they can harvest your own stem cells, expand them, and reintroduce them back into your body. Either way, the goal is the same, restoring your body's ability to repair itself. But there's another way that you can boost stem cell mobilization and activity. Exercise. Now, it shouldn't come as any surprise. Exercise seems to be one of the best things that you can do to turn back the clock on aging. Most exercise demands some sort of tissue growth or repair. So it would naturally follow that there's a biological imperative to link challenging physical activity with stem cell stimulation. Push your body and stem cells activate. It's how we heal. It's how we grow. Now, like I said before, as you age, your stem cells age with you. They lose potency. That's where traditional stem cell therapy comes in. Harvesting and growing these cells outside of your body is a big advantage. Now, in modern medicine, stem cell therapy is used to treat a variety of cancers of the blood and a handful of immunological conditions. Now, for now, that's all the FDA and other health agencies around the world recognize as valid therapeutic uses of stem cell therapy. For example, a bone marrow transplant. Donated cells replace the blood and immune system of a leukemia patient. It's a life-saving procedure. But that's a pretty narrow use case for stem cells, something that's evolved to be the all-purpose repair system for the body. That's why a lot of researchers and scientists now believe that the potential for stem cells goes far beyond that. They think that this therapy can play a major role in regenerative medicine and anti-aging. The idea is not so much to turn back the age clock at the fundamental level, but rather to reverse the decline of critical organs and tissues by boosting repair. The cardiovascular system, the central nervous system, the immune system, systems that keep us alive, but systems that break down over time. Now, stem cells are not all the same. They typically fall into two general categories: pluripotent stem cells, which can become any cell in the body, and multipotent stem cells, which are more limited. They can only differentiate into a limited number of cell types. The best example of a pluripotent stem cell, embryonic stem cells. They can and do turn into every different type of cell in the body. But since they are usually harvested from unused embryos planned for in vitro fertilization, there are ethical barriers. And because of this, these stem cells are neither widely used nor readily available. But there's another way. We can create pluripotent stem cells from adult tissues by using the Yamanaka factors, a set of four genes that can actually reprogram somatic cells into what are called induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs. Now, the tech is still pretty immature. It's not yet advanced enough to grow whole organs or rejuvenate tissues on a large scale, but it's already making an impact. iPSCs are already being used in drug discovery, in disease modeling, in genetic engineering research. Okay, that's pluripotent stem cells. Let's take a look at multipotent stem cells. The most important types are neural stem cells, hematopoietic stem cells, endothelial stem cells, and mesenchymal stem cells, or MSCs. That last type, mesenchymal stem cells, is especially relevant to the anti-aging field. These cells have additional special growth factors that make them especially useful for tissue repair and maintenance, and they're relatively widespread. They're present in bone, muscle, cartilage, fat, and other tissues. But the richest source of mesenchymal stem cells? Bone marrow. The problem is harvesting them using bone marrow aspiration can be invasive and not without risks. A less invasive way is to get MSCs from fat tissue. And these cells have been shown to rejuvenate skin in old and diabetic mice. But there's a non-invasive way to collect mesenchymal stem cells: umbilical cords. Normally discarded after birth, they hold a hidden treasure. Umbilical cord-derived mesenchymal stem cells are very potent stem cells, much more potent than adult stem cells. That's because of their youth. But even better, because they come from the umbilical cord and not the baby itself, they are not genetically encoded to that individual or any individual, which means they'll work for anyone because they don't elicit an immune response when they're infused into genetically divorced people, like blood. But one of the best things about stem cells is not that they can transform into other types of cells as needed. A major characteristic of stem cells is that they produce exosomes. Exosomes are extracellular vesicles that contain bioactive molecules like growth factors and anti-inflammatory molecules, and cell signaling molecules. That's how cells communicate. Now, exosomes are produced by both stem cells and adult cells. But the stem cell exosomes contain some unique and especially potent growth factors that reflect the primary function of the stem cell, which is tissue repair and maintenance. Now, in the case of mesenchymal stem cells, their exosomes contain RNA, peptides, proteins, cytokines, and lipids that elicit growth and immune modulating effects. When injected into the bloodstream, stem cells don't just float around aimlessly. Stem cells and their exosomes tend to be drawn towards tissues that are damaged and inflamed. It seems inflammation acts as a signal. The damaged tissues secrete cytokines. Now, these cytokines signal stem cells to congregate there and deliver their special growth, repair, and immune modulating payload, a natural repair system guided by the body's own distress signals. thanks to this behavior, these stem cells have the potential to act as a kind of whole body tune-up, a way to restore balance. The anti-inflammatory effect is especially important for aged tissues. Inflammation, chronic low-grade inflammation, is now recognized as a primary factor in age-related tissue degeneration. It drives skin deterioration, cardiovascular disease, neurodegenerative conditions, all linked to inflammation. Now, what's interesting is that infused stem cells generally do not appear to take up residence in the damaged tissues, not for long anyway. Instead, it's these special signaling molecules from the exosomes that do the job. They stimulate the tissue's own healthy cells along with indigenous stem cells to do the repair work. Now, this process is known as the Paracrine effect. But mesenchymal stem cells have another advantage. They can be cultured or expanded. A small harvest from umbilical cord or fat tissue can be grown into a much larger number of cells, into millions of cells. Now, this expansion technology isn't simple or easy. There's both art and science to it. And if not done properly, many of the stem cells will become senescent or lose their more potent growth and immune modulating properties. There's a whole body of research that's focused on optimizing stem cell expansion, and the field is rapidly advancing. This is why anti-aging clinics around the world prefer mesenchymal stem cells for those seeking rejuvenation. But some clinics go further. They use more differentiated stem cells, like neural stem cells or bone stem cells, injected directly into the targeted tissues. These have a greater potential to regenerate damaged joints or nerves, but the procedures are more complex and they represent greater risk. Some of the biggest limitations for the use of stem cell therapy for anti-aging is the regulatory hurdles put in place by the FDA and similar organizations in other countries. That's because no human clinical trials have tested stem cell therapy specifically for anti-aging. Most government health agencies, at least in the US, don't support longevity-focused therapies. So it's unlikely that these types of trials will be funded by taxpayer money anytime soon. Now, fortunately, there's a lot of privately funded research going into this field right now. That's why, at least for the time being, most stem cell therapy for longevity happens elsewhere, in less regulated regions, places like India, China, Mexico, Panama, and at RMI in Costa Rica. These clinics have proliferated in the last several years. Their rise mirrors the boom in longevity-focused healthcare, and along with this boom is the rise of clinics and practitioners that are, well, let's just say less than scrupulous. And for the uneducated consumer, it can be hard to tell the difference. Now, I'm going to try to address that in an upcoming video, so stay tuned. Stem cells are the body's natural repair system. But as we age, their numbers shrink and their power fades. And that decline contributes to the aging process itself. But science is fighting back. New therapies and strategies are emerging to restore and enhance stem cell function. Lifestyle interventions like exercise and nutrition, direct stem cell therapies, and cutting-edge therapies like induced pluripotent stem cells. Now, obviously, the field is still evolving. It's in its infancy, but the potential to slow or even reverse certain aspects of aging is undeniable. As research continues, these advances could become a cornerstone of longevity science, offering hope for a healthier, more resilient future. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out of here. Check out my free school community if you'd like to learn more about human longevity. Catch you guys next time.